Surface consistent residual statics in gplatform are calculated using the Statics Surface Consistent module. This module will calculate a surface consistent residual statics correction for your gathers via a correlation-based iterative process. To run surface consistent statics, load in some gathers with coordinates and bins already set. You can choose to load gathers with your NMO correction already applied, or you can load uncorrected gathers and apply the NMO within the module itself. If you are using uncorrected gathers, change the input gathers type under NMO to gathers without NMO and set the parameters for your NMO correction, including a velocity model and replacement velocity. This is useful when running tests with different velocity fields, as you do not have to waste storage space with multiple sets of NMO gathers. You may also choose to import additional statics from another module that will be taken into account when you run surface-consistent statics. Once your gathers have been loaded, you can go ahead and create a base stack. The base stack is the CMP stack of your gathers before residual statics correction. We can now use this stack to determine our model parameters here. Calculation start and end time indicates which portion of the data the program will use for the model. The times you choose here will show up on your base stack, so you can see if you are covering the correct area for your statics calculation. The maximum static shift indicates the largest shift that the program will allow for. The correlation length indicates the length of the cross-correlation function for the calculation. It should be at least 4 times the maximum shift parameter. Set the correlation threshold between 0 and 1. This indicates the threshold at which a correlation will be accepted for your statics correction. The number of iterations and the number of iteratively reweighted solutions indicate how many iterations the program will run and the number of times it will run those iterations respectively. Each new solution will use the result of the previous one if you select more than one iteratively reweighted solution. We are now ready to run a test of our statics. Before we run statics, go down to Visualization Settings and check off the Create Stacks option. This will show us our output stack with the statics correction applied on each step that is specified by the parameter here. When running on a 3D dataset, inline and crossline fields refer to the stack sections which will be used for this statics QC. When using this option, the program will generate a new base stack for your data. I ran the statics module earlier. As you run statics, you can see the various graph views update with each iteration that the program runs. The stack energy gradually improves with each iteration, and you can use this graph to determine the number of iterations you would like to use for your final statics run. In this case, the stack energy levels out after 6 iterations, so we can set the number of iterations to 6. The other views also help us to QC our parameters by showing the stack energy improvement by CMP and the actual shift applied for each CMP, in addition to the average energy of our solution. The stack with your new statics applied is added as another layer on top of the base stack. Cycle through the layers by holding down Shift and Control and using the scroll wheel of your mouse, or by selecting the stack you would like to see by moving it up in the Vista Items section of View Properties. There are several other parameters you may want to consider adjusting to fine-tune the output of the Statics module. Under Advanced, you can have the program use a CMP term, a coordinate map static term, and a residual RMO term in the solution. Use RMO to account for imperfections in your velocity model. If you select Multi-Maximum Solving, it allows the program to use more than one term at a time in its solution. If you like the result of your static solution, but think it can be improved by further iterations of statics, you can pick up where you left off by checking off the Use Previous Result button and running the statics module again. This will pick up the last iteration of statics from your previous run and use it as the beginning for your current run. The temp directory parameter defines the directory where static solutions for each iteration will be stored. You can then use any iteration of statics, not just the latest iteration, as the basis for the new statics run. Save your statics to the database by going to the Output Data tab and selecting the Output Static item. Right-click and select Save to DB. Give your new static item a name. To apply your static shift to your gathers going forward, use the Apply Static Shifts module inside a seismic loop. The statics correction can also be retrieved from this module or from the database at any time. For more information, please check out our other tutorial videos or visit us at geomage.com.